Hello, and welcome to another episode of Set-4-Life Conversations, where we help you get your mind right and your money right by discussing life strategies for the everyday person. I'm your host, Thomas Lacoma, and each episode, we'll spend some time with financial advisor, pastor, and motivational speaker, published author, and former college athlete, George Thompson, as he shares with us wisdom that you can put into practice today. Ever had that feeling like there's just too much on your shoulders? That feeling of overwhelm? In today's episode, we discuss how to shortcut the overwhelm and take back control. We also share with you a free resource that is available to you right now that can help you thrive financially in today's atmosphere. All right, let's get into this. All right, George, before we get into the meat of today's episode, I want to talk to you about a very powerful event that you were a part of last week. Let me just pull it up here on my monitor so everybody can see. Hold on here. It is. Can you see that, George?
Yes.
Yeah. So Bishop Moody's Financial Empowerment Seminar has some really great speakers. Bishop Moody. Van Moody has a passion for transforming people. We had Bishop DeAndre Salter.
Yes.
He has a passion for helping people become more financially stable. And then we had this dude here, George Thompson.
Your humble servant.
And everybody knows who that is. And then Bob Dickerson does a lot of stuff with the community, helping people with getting money into their hands. So I listened to a little bit of it, and it was really impressive. So I wanted you to share a little bit. Just give a little background on some of the things that were talked about, some of the things that people were able to learn from that session.
Right. Thank you, Thomas. And I was so honored to be able to do that. I was supposed to go on April 4th to Bishop Moody's church in Birmingham, Alabama, and to review and to go over and do a financial conference, me and Bishop DeAndre Salter. But then obviously because of all the stay-at-home orders and things like that, we did not go. So we wanted to set up a conference and have it online. And it was really a blessing. So it was blessed from the beginning to the end. It was 5 hours. So it was a blessing. And I was also, three very surprising things that was really how God blessed it was, is that how many people stayed the entire time? Because that was one of the challenges I thought we would have. It started off by laying some foundation. And then we talked about some things you want to do right now financially. Then I taught a session called Building Generational Wealth, because a generation is like every 20 years, and how to do it in this environment. There's a lot of people that are saying, oh, everything's down. But this actually is an opportunity that creates a lot of opportunity. Then after that, me and Bob went over all the resources that are available. There's a lot of things from the government. You've seen the stimulus plan that went through, the CARES Act that was $2.2 trillion so far. And we went over just what to do with your stimulus check. Then we also went for businesses. There's something called a paycheck protection program and how it ran out of money within the first 13 days. And now there's a second round that's going out. And we're not going to talk about now all the people, the corporations that got the money and the small business. But we had a really good conversation about how that should have really went to smaller, under 100 full-time employees, and being able to help them and making the dollar figures less, like making the maximum $500,000 maybe for 6 months. And then if they hired everybody back, then they could come back and get another $500,000, like into just to keep going.
So then more people could benefit from it.
Right. And we could share a lot of ideas that we'll also be able to share with the people that are politicians and things like that. But that was really good to do resource. Then I came back and I kind of concluded with one on investing. And I call it the rubber band effect. I'm going to say it three times. The rubber band effect. That is that, you know, when the markets are down, that's actually a good time to invest. And I was talking about just different things that people should be doing investment wise to create a rubber band effect where they can kind of go down, but then spring forward. So I walked through that, and it was really a blessing. All the comments that we're getting back and all of the email and also a lot of emails. Because over 800 people were on the line when I was at the conference.
That's awesome.
So it was very well attended. They had over 1,000 reservations and RSVP. So we'll also it's recorded, so there are different areas that we can talk about, and I'm sure we'll go over different areas that we can have that, and I'll be doing more in that area, because I was really it was really good to hear all of the feedback from the generational wealth about what you should be doing now, but also mm-hmm. most importantly, and I'm sure we'll talk about this later, to not just look down at your current situation, but to look down the road at things that can be happening in the future.
Yeah, I think a lot of the conversation was around how to set yourself up now. Once we come out of this, to be even in a better place than you were before, right?
Right.
So for all the people listening, I am going to include in the show notes for today's episode a link to the replay of the seminar. So if you want to go ahead and learn how to make sure you're not missing out on any aspect of your financial life, even in the midst of our current situation. So just check it out in the show notes. The link will be there for the full replay. If you want to listen to the full 4 hours, you want to fast forward to the sections you want to listen to, it'll all be there. So George, today I want to take on the topic of focus.
Focus.
This is something that you and I have talked about at length over the years. So I wanted to start off by talking about being overwhelmed, because you make a correlation between this and focus. Listen to these definitions that I got off Google for the word overwhelm. The first one said, bury or drown beneath a huge mass. A second one was defeat completely. And in these times that we're in, what do you see today and how people are feeling overwhelmed with so many aspects of their lives?
Yes, I want to actually go back to some of those definitions. But first, I just want to let you know, we've been taking an unofficial poll. I would say unofficial because I'm asking everybody questions whenever we meet, when I meet with clients, when I'm coaching small businesses, pastors, and individuals. I ask this question. I say, since we've been staying at home and we have not been going into the office, are you working harder, the same, or less than what you were working when you went into the office? And 80% of the people are saying that they're working harder. We actually only have one in the whole time that says they're working less. Then most people that, and this is the other startling statistic, is the other 18-19% that are saying they're working the same work a lot of hours already anyway. Meaning like they're working 10 and 12 hours. So they may be going in somewhere, meaning they're essential. So everyone is saying they're working harder. And then that creates a couple other things about being overwhelmed. A lot of times we weren't ready to work from home. Also, I'm just raising my hand now. Our homes are not set up to work from home. I almost want to say people overwhelmed. You know who's the most overwhelmed person, the most overwhelmed thing in our household? Our Wi-Fi network. I do calls and I'm on it, right? And we're right. And then I have three children. They're on there going to school online. Then my wife is on. We're all on that network. And I'll be talking. And just by the way, if I fall off and come back, it's nothing personal. It's under stress. So then there's certain things you need to do to get that off the stress off it. So what did I do? I actually got a new modem and then a new router system that also can work within ranges. George, you asked a question about me, not about Wi-Fi, but you actually need to do the same thing. So the first thing that we need to do when we get overwhelmed is we need to decide what we're going to do about that.
Okay. Yeah. And I think one of the things you teach about in your books is this shortcut that you can take when you're feeling overwhelmed. I want you to talk a little bit about that.
Right. So before I talk about that, though, I want to say the first thing we need to have is a plan. Mm-hmm. When everybody talks about something, we have to have a plan. So you're going to hear me say that mm-hmm. over and again, a plan. So what we do during Set-4-Life, and then also you're going to make this available to everybody, is we do something called a focus day. I've got to say everything three times. Sorry, my passion is my focus day. Excuse me. So how we want to do a focus day is we actually want to take our day, and then it writes down every minute of the day, meaning like, let's say 5:15, 5:30, 5:45, 6 o'clock. You see, I said 5 because it's in. Mm-hmm. Sometimes that's the time we need to work, get up so we can work out. Then what we do is we write down what we want to accomplish that day. And then we do it that day, because mm-hmm. I'm seeing a lot of times that people are saying they're overwhelmed, or actually even worse than being overwhelmed is frozen, Frozen mm-hmm. and overwhelmed are running neck and neck, meaning there's so much to do, you don't know what to do. So then what people do is they take a simple list, a very simple list, and they start writing down just a to-do list. But what's better than a to-do list is you want to make a focus page where you write down everything you're going to do during the day and do that.
So and put times against it, right?
Every time is written right on that sheet. So it says 5:15, 5:30, every 15 minutes of the day. Then on the other side of the paper, it says what we actually got completed. So then you're starting to match up what your focus is and what you got, what you accomplished. And then that helps you towards your long-term goal. If you remember, what we're always teaching people in Set-4-Life is desire, focus, accountability, and consistency. Mm-hmm. But without focus is how you get things done. Mm-hmm. Sorry, take this from them and say, how we make it do what it do, Ray Charles. We have to sit down and say, how do we get our goals accomplished? So now, so then we walk through them by having a focus day.
Yeah, I know for myself, I've gone through both extremes in this period of, you know, being home full time. I remember I had a period where I was kind of frozen in one place. I wake up every day and just kind of saunter down to my desk, you know, stay at the screen all day, have lunch, come back, and just feel like I'm not really moving to the pace that I wanted to. And then I had other times when I was just doing so much, like I had things with the kids, I had like family time, then I have my stuff I'm doing for work, I have all these projects that are due, and I'm sleeping like 2-3 hours. So then at some point, I just sat back and took a look at it. And it was similar to what you said, I just blocked out a bunch of things on a piece of paper. And I said, hey, these are the key things that really need to keep getting done every day. Right. And then in my work calendar, what I do now is I make blocks of time in the work calendar for particular things. If I get assigned something, I say it's going to get done in this window of time. Right. So that even if things change, I move that block somewhere else.
Right.
But that work didn't go away. Because what happens when you push stuff forward, sometimes eventually too many things were pushed and they're all stacked together.
Right.
And then you feel overwhelmed, right?
Right. Yeah. So it's so good that you're saying this. So everyone, at some point, we're going to talk about affirmations. So you want to write this down. I live my life by design, not by default. Mm-hmm. So when you live your life by design, you're designing your day. So there's two sides to what you just said and what I just said. Mm-hmm. So side number one is frozen. That means you just don't do anything. You're not working at optimum. So you're just going a little bit. You're going a little bit slower. So everything's just kind of going a little bit slower. So you're getting up. You're not, you know, let's say not taking a shower, just in your pajamas, doing whatever anybody else is asking you to do. That's mm-hmm. called survival mode. We want to move into design mode, which is the mm-hmm. other side where you write out a plan. So that is get up in the morning. Then what I do is I have prayer time in the morning. I do prayer time first. Then I do my own private meditation. And then I do Bible study. Mm-hmm. After that, I work out because that's the time I can work out by my time to work out. Then my day starts of breakfast, kids up, getting them going, things like that. Then I start my first meetings. So yeah. I have to have that preload. That's that workout prior to achieving.
Mental and physical.
Now, if I don't do that, what happens? I'm going to get fatter, to say that way. I'm going to get bigger. Mm-hmm. Then also, am I going to be mentally prepared? Because we're praying for people. We're talking to you. There's a lot of things going on where we want to make sure we're doing that. So that's self-care time. That we want to be able to do that. Then I have time where I do homework with my kids every day that's non-negotiable. And Tom, I'm the PE teacher. So I'm physical education, and I actually play with each one of my kids basketball. If we decide to do basketball, volleyball, or we go for a walk or whatever, I do it individually most of the time.
Mm-hmm. Yep, so that's I remember you saying that.
And this is something later on. I know we're not covering it today. There's something called a perfect day. We're going to not cover that today, though. But you see, I'm designing my day to where I get all the goals that I want to accomplish. Then we later on, this is so beautiful, we're going to set up an hour for just when people call you, or I have to return phone calls that are emergency, or just a time when I can let unplanned things happen. so that I can do them, whether it's kids, whether it's work or in that relation, to be able to do it. But you have to plan for that, because sometimes people come in, I'm doing a little tsunami. They come in and then they try to change our whole day. So that's why we want to have it by design, not by default.
Yep. I like that. I like that. Live life by design, not by default.
It's in the book.
Yep. Before we continue, I want to let everybody listening know that if you have a question that you'd like George to answer, it can be anything, finances, relationships, getting things done. There's a couple ways that you can get your questions to us. The first is in the show notes. Click the link in the show notes of this episode where you can leave us your question as a voice recording. You can do this right from your phone. It's actually pretty cool. And then we'll get that directly. And we may even play your voice as you ask your question. Just make sure to tell us who you are or a little bit about yourself. If you want to stay anonymous, that's fine too. And then the second way you can reach us is you can follow George on Facebook. The link for that will also be in the show notes. So Facebook is the best way to reach out to him if you have a question or you want to see what he's up to. Third is you can hit me up on my social media locations. I am at TZ Lucoma everywhere, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. Instagram and Facebook are my most active ones, so you can reach us there. So we've talked quite a bit about overwhelm and then how to get past that overwhelm through things like planning the beginning of your day and having that block that's just for you so that you can center your mind and your body, your spirit. And then once in a while doing what we call the focus day, where you can break down a day into the segments of time and tasks and just kind of bang it out. One thing that I was thinking as we're talking about this is how can we, once we've shortcutted that feeling of overwhelm, how can we kind of just completely take back that control and really feel like we're in the driver's seat in terms of focus and getting things done?
Thomas, that's a great question. First of all, how we actually do that is we actually do that through the focus day. Because actually, if we start doing the focus day and we have a focus day and we start achieving our goals, our mindset begins to change so that now we can do more than one focus day at a time. And then other people know that, like, hey, when someone gives something to you and says, hey, I need this accomplished by this and when, then we can automatically start doing that. So we have a mechanism in place that happens. Then what happens? Then our anxiety goes down. Then our feeling of overwhelm goes down because we're achieving our goals. And that's how we actually live our life, by design, not by default. So we do that by doing the mechanism. And then as we begin to do that, then everyone kind of gets programmed into that. Like I'm almost at the point with my children where they already start putting their stuff on to go outside to play basketball. They already know, and they're doing it so that you can start managing people. Because one of the times we used to hear people say, my boss, they're always giving me this and that. And what happens is you kind of start telling, hey, do you have anything? I set aside this time for us to be able to do this or be able to do that. So you start designing, then other people see, hey, you know what? I was looking at him. I was looking at her. They don't look as stressed. Why are they not stressed? So they see how they do it. Just like how when people see how we invest, they go, oh, I see. They're not bothered. Why are they not bothered? Then they kind of start seeing how you live your life. That's the best example. In other words, like your testimony is a good example. And that's why we always use them. And won't do the Panda Express story, but we did that yesterday because the kids did good on their math. So they can do Panda, but we did not order any drinks. Everybody, so if you're just tuning in, you don't know who I am. I don't buy any drinks for my sodas or any drinks for my children. I take that money and I invest it for them. So it's like a lifestyle. So you have a lifestyle of design, not by default. So when people come to you with something crazy, then you kind of know how to react to it.
Yeah. And I think the thing about focus also, it's important to understand your own personality and what's going to work. Like we always talk about this, what works for some people doesn't work for other people. And I know, I'll give you the example. I have three kids and they're all homeschooled. And my wife and I are always talking about how they're wired differently because trying to get them buckle down and do their work. Right. So my older daughter is very independent. And so she's driven by being able to keep that independence. Yeah. So if you tell her you need to get this done by this time, organize yourself, get it done. She'll go ahead work on that, because she's very driven, and she's 15, so she's more responsible. She's very driven and wants to achieve like a million goals. My middle daughter, for a while, there was a little bit of struggle with the focus, but what we understand about her personality is she's very rules and order driven. So my wife came up with this spreadsheet where she put in everything that she needs to do during the day. She broke down her curriculum and she kind of just checks in the spreadsheet as she's doing things during the day. That has made a big difference in terms of how she keeps her focus during the school day. Yeah. My son, he's 9. And his mind is all over the place. So every day with him, there's like a checklist. And I'm sitting here doing my work and I'm saying, how is your checklist going? Because that's the only way to refocus him back. Because he still goes, you know, starts doing one thing, goes to another thing. So we're still trying to learn with him how to get that focus. But the reason I gave that example is that learn yourself and like figure out for yourself how to get back into that focus. There's some principles, but then you got to apply them to yourself. Right.
What you just described is one of the parts of the essence of Set for Life. Mm-hmm. It is achieving goals your way. You set the goals and you work through them. Those are great illustrations with your children, because what you outlined with each child was a plan for each one. And then when you got to your son, I'm sorry, I almost had to jump up and start screaming, because I have 2 8-year-olds and a 6. So we went out and got a big, huge board with math, English, B, with everything written on it. And then you get to put a star on when it's done. So I don't have to ask nobody how they're doing, because if I ask them, they'll tell me they're doing fine. So I'm like, all I want to do is let's put that star up so we can go down and then really important, and then we'll cover this at a later conference, but I want to just make sure we say it now. There's something called rewards and consequences. In life, when you do stuff, there's rewards and there's consequences. First of all, most of us that work, our reward is we get paid. The consequences, we won't. That's if you're in sales, any organization's rewards and consequences. We want to start teaching that actually to our children now, is there's rewards and there's consequences. Because what you want to do is you're teaching accountability.
Yeah.
And that's what makes people go. So also one part of also your focus is actually to have rewards and consequences. We'll cover that during our consistency phases.
Excellent. Well, this was a great episode. I think there's a lot of nuggets that everybody's going to get from what we learned today. So thank you, everybody, for joining us on another episode of Set for Life Conversations with George. If you found value from what you heard today, there's a couple of things we'd like you to do to help us serve you even better. As I mentioned earlier, if you have a question that you want to be answered, drop us a message using the link in the show notes of this episode, or hit us up on social media. If you're interested in going deeper in any of the topics that George teaches about, one of the best ways to do that is to get one of his books from the Ready, Set, Grow series. You can find a link to that in the show notes as well. And if you just want to learn about George and what he's about, check out his website at www.georgebthompson.com. Thank you once again for joining us, and we're excited to keep sharing more conversations with you. We are all on this journey with you and feel like we're going to grow as you grow.